All right. How you doing? It is the radio guy, the Dr. Mike Prince. Welcome to another episode of the Mike Prince Show, coming to you Mondays through Fridays, exclusively on the Open Mic Broadcast Network. Follow me on Twitter at Radio Guy, Instagram, Radio Guy 22. The website is obnradio.com. And of course, if you're on the go, you can check us out at 605-477-5066. And in the Prairie View community, check us out at 87.9 FM. Well, we got through the MEAC Media Day with success. We had some hiccups to begin the program, but everything else turned out smooth sailing. You can always go back and check that out at obnradio.com or spreaker.com, spreaker.com. Look up Open Mic Broadcast Network and look for MEAC. Very, very strong performance. A lot of live listeners and even guys listening on the on-demand. So always encourage you guys to go back if you miss out on anything here from the Mike Prince Show. As you know, it is the start of football camp. PV Nation on the grind under the Dooley era. And Panthers come out with a new look. And that new look is simply now that the offense are wearing the dark purples. Defense was wearing the gold. Kind of a mustard gold. Not the Dijon mustard gold, but a mustard Frenchie's gold. But nonetheless, they were getting it done, getting it in. Day three of training camp came to a conclusion on yesterday, and we'll hear the assessments of Coach Eric Dooley and how the Panthers are looking from his point of view.
I thought the guys came out with a lot of energy. They retained a lot from the past 2 days, and I was very pleased with that. But the energy side of it, the effort, the way we started off practice, high intensity, guys was flying around, offense was moving, lining up, snapping the ball, defense was flying around. I was very pleased with it, but we still got a long ways to go. We're just heading down the right way. First 2 days, I think we got better each day. That's what I'm looking for, to get better each day. But we still got a long ways to go. But I like what we're doing in all three phases of the game. We just got to continue to work to get better.
And, of course, that was Coach Eric Dooley. We'd like to thank Dwayne Lewis, SID, for the Panthers, getting us those sound bites that we can get over here to you. Coach Dooley says that he's still working some things out, ironing out some wrinkles, if you would, and working on improvements, things of improvement. Now, there's no secret that a huge contributing part of the Panthers' offense has transferred Mr. Hollins, which left still three quarterbacks, one true freshman, then a sophomore and senior. And from my note-taking and from my observations, if I were to go right now today and pick my starting quarterback, it would be Jalen Morton. That's just my opinion. Why I say that, Morton looked very comfortable in the pocket, flowed and executed with the team precisely. In fact, took the team down the field to score in two plays. Accuracy was on. Reading his progressions was on. Looked great. Then we have freshman Travion Connolly. Looked a bit uncomfortable, had some happy feet, but he's a true freshman. He comes from a strong football pedigree, coming from Tatum High School. So I don't doubt if he'll be ready as he gets accustomed to seeing things amplified just a little bit more. Then we have McCullers. McCullers came in, big expectations, transfer student. In fact, Hollins relieved him of duties last season where he saw the phenomenal outbreak of the 22 touchdowns in six games. Also, because of that success, it was suggested that McCullers would start concentrating on the wide receiver position. The kid is truly athletic, amazingly athletic. But as far as comfort in the pocket, it appears that he may have had some happy feet. It appears. But nonetheless, it was only day three of training. So there's still a lot of football to be unfolded, a lot to be broken down. And we'll find out just where all this will settle in the long run. Meanwhile, there are some whispers of a transfer student. I don't want to call them out just yet. There has been tweets and sightings about a commitment being made. But you have to go through the process, and I don't want to jinx that process until he actually lands on campus. So we'll keep an eye and an ear out for that. Another sleeper that you might want to keep an eye out for is Tristan Wallace, transfer student, originally a quarterback in high school. But man, did he look good running his routes? Did he look good catching those passes? Excited to see how he develops. He's only a sophomore. That's an upswing for PV Nation. And I tell you something else that I looked at, because I'm always looking for those side notes and the special teams play. And long snapper Danny Garza looked awesome. I know people don't put a lot of emphasis in the long snapper, but a long snapper is so key to your punting games, so key to your field goal attempts, so key to your point after tries. And this kid was accurate. I'm going to say 96% of the times he was snapping the ball. I was thoroughly impressed with him. Only a sophomore. And you had Amari Martinez, punter. Looked pretty good. Pretty decent hang time on his punts. Still getting some of the accuracy down. But for the most part, special teams looking to part. And I cannot emphasize enough at how massive Holcomb is over everyone else on the field. The big tight end transfer is a specimen. And I'm pretty sure that Coach KJ Black is working out this young man to be, you can't even hide a guy that's huge. You can't even try to hide him. Just put him in the slot and hope you can stick up with him. He has strong hands, exceptional speed, and overall just seemed to be putting in the grind and the work. So we'll see how all of that unfolds. Defensively, I got to admit, I looked at it, kind of skimmed over it, but I was more concentrated on the offensive side for the first look, being that that was the most notable impact of change. But however, you hear Coach Dooley state that there's work to be done, and just like we all know, August 25th will be upon us before we know it. And that's where the rubber meets the road. But we will give you more updates, insights, and tidbits as the camp unfolds. As we continue to move forward, I want to remind you that we come to you daily, 10 a.m. Central Standard Time, giving you something that you could use, at least we hope that you can use, in regards to the world of HBCU. And because you have spoken, we have heard your cry. We are now in production of providing you with a live Saturday morning broadcast at 10 a.m. Central Standard Time. Stay tuned for that as we develop that and unfold that. Once again, I want to thank you guys so much for your participation in our live broadcast coverage of the MEAC Media Day coverage. Great run. Added a couple of new schools to our weekly list: Delaware State, Morgan State, of course, Howard, FAMU will be part of that package. And we can't wait to get things going. I want to also remind you that during the regular season of PV football 2018, at the conclusion of each game, 30 minutes at the conclusion of the games, you can check us out live with our 1876 After Party postgame report. We'll take your calls. We'll break down the game and just have a grand old time after the game. That's why we call it the After Party. Well, I must exit stage left for now. But as always, we appreciate you from near and far. Remember, our message line for you to call in and leave your comments, questions, or concerns is 713-570-6736. Don't forget to follow me on Twitter at Radio Guy. Instagram is Radio Guy 22. The website is obnradio.com. And until the next time, you guys be blessed. I am the doctor, the Radio Guy, Mike Prince, and we'll see you on the other side.